And as the international picture escalates, there is a huge sense of shock globally at just how China managed to put a lid on the epidemic. Other countries are eager to learn both good and bad experiences and the measures which proved most effective. Distance working and online conferencing have become ever more prevalent in 2020. And this one is a little bit different. The online platform is to help international medical institutions learn from China's experiences over the past 2 months. And the medics are not only holding pharmaceutical discussions.
Our viewpoint, I think our medical team, is that antivirals, if there's any candidates, may only be used at the initial period of the infection, the initial stage. As we observe from our patients, as we are treating almost all the critically ill patients, at the late stage, antivirals may not have such a big effect.
It's also providing psychological advice in these times of extreme stress and uncertainty.
Especially, you should make them believe that they are going to win. They are going to win this battle.
Lessons which didn't come easy or cheap. The discussions go into great detail to ensure advice is adaptable to local situations. Many rounds of such online consultations are being held with different countries around the world.
Where the Chinese government has placed its experience on the table for African countries to be able to see use as an example.
Meanwhile, Chinese medical teams are now bringing their experiences and equipment to the hardest hit areas. Among those include Italy and Iran. One group has arrived in Serbia.
Everything in this plane and everything inside the next plane is free help and donations from the People's Republic of China. We are infinitely thankful for this, and particularly for Chinese experts. They've stood up as friends when it is difficult for us. They've shone as a friend when we are fighting for the survival of Serbia.
Highly sought after medical supplies are also being delivered to dozens of countries around the world. Not only from governments, but also donations from civil organizations and individuals. The virus is new, and one we still know relatively little about. All the more reason to unite and cooperate rather than going it alone.